Hello, welcome to my channel. In this tutorial, I would like to share how I created this neon lower third animation. Here I am using a third party plugin. This plugin is a 100% free plugin. The plugin is called Saber from Video Copilot. I will leave a link in the description. If you want the plugin, you can download that. Check the link in the description. Before getting into the topic, I would like to thank you for being here and supporting me. If you are new to this channel, consider subscribing, that would be highly appreciated. Don't skip the video, please watch the video completely. Let's not waste any more of the time. Let's get started. Open up After Effects. I have imported the YouTube play icon to create this lower third animation. Create a new composition and name it as main. I am using a 1920 by 1080 composition with a frame rate of 30 and a duration of 8 seconds. Click on the rectangle tool, set the fill to none and stroke to solid color. Set the stroke width to 15. I am creating a rectangle, center align the rectangle. Name the shape layer as box. Bring in the YouTube icon into the composition and scale it down to your requirement. Create another shape, click on the pen tool and create a line as shown. Name the shape layer as line. Click on the box layer and go to layer and click on auto trace. Click OK on the dialog box and bring down the auto trace layer above the box layer. Do the same with the line layer. Bring up the YouTube icon above the all layers. Select the line layer and the auto traced line layer and right click and click on pre-compose. Name the composition as line. Select the box layer and the auto-traced box layer and right click and click on pre-compose and name the composition as box. Create a new text layer and type in your text. I am typing in my name, that is my channel name. And position it according to your need. Create another text layer. I am typing in subscribe. I am reducing the font size. Position it according to your need. Create a new solid layer and name the solid as Saber. Select the subscribe text layer and the Saber layer and right click and click on pre-compose. Name the composition as subscribe Saber and click on move all attributes and click OK. Create another solid layer and name it as Saber. Select the main text layer and the Saber layer and right click and click on pre-compose. Name the composition as RB Raudran Saber. Click on move all attributes and click OK. Open the main text Saber layer and search for Saber from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the Saber solid layer. Select the preset as neon. Set the glow intensity to 15%. The customize core, set the core type to text layer and the text layer to the main text. In the render settings, set the composite settings to transparent. Do the same for the subtext layer. Search for Saber from the effects and preset panel and apply it into the Saber solid layer. Set the preset to neon, glow intensity to 15%. In the customize core, set the core type to text layer to the subtext layer. And in the render settings, set the composite settings to transparent. move up the YouTube icon layer above all the layers. Open up the line layer and apply the saber effect to the auto traced line layer. Set the preset to neon. In the customize core, set the core type to layer masks. Set the glow intensity to 25%. In the render settings, set the composite settings to transparent. Do the same to the box layer. Open the box layer and apply the saber effect to the auto traced box layer. Set the preset to neon, glow intensity to 25%. In the customize core, set the core type to layer masks. In the render settings, set the composite settings to transparent. At the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for start and set the percentage to 100%. At 1 second mark, set the start offset to 0%. Set the end size to 0%. At 15 second mark, set the end offset value to 100%. At 1 second 15 frame mark, set the end offset value to 0%. Now RAM preview this. At 3 second mark, set the end offset value to 100%. Create a keyframe for end size at 3 second mark and set the value to 200%. At 1 second 15 frame mark, set the end size value to 0%. Now RAM preview this. That's looking better. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open up graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now RAM preview this. Go to the main composition. Create a new solid layer, set the fill to solid color and set the stroke to none. Create a shape layer as shown. Duplicate the shape layer and name the shape layer as main text mat and subtext mat, that is channel name RB Raudran mat and subscribe mat. Bring down the two mat layers above their saber compositions respectively. Set the track mat of the main text saber layer to alpha main text mat layer. Set the track mat of the subtext saber layer to subtext mat layer. Open the main text saber layer and bring up the position property. Create a keyframe at 1 second mark. At the start of the timeline, position the main text saber layer as shown. Select the two keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open up graph editor and change the graph as shown. Press P to bring up the position property of the subtext saber layer. Create a keyframe at 1 second 15 frame mark. And at 15 second mark, position the subtext saber layer as shown. Select the two keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now RAM preview this. I would like that subtext layer coming much more earlier, so I am moving forward the keyframes. Now RAM preview this. Yeah, that's looking better. Create a new solid layer. Press T to bring up the opacity property. And at 15 second mark, create a keyframe and set the value to 0%. and at 4 second 15 frame mark, create a keyframe with 0% opacity. At 5 second mark, set the opacity to 100%. At the start of the timeline, set the opacity to 100%. Set the in and out points and RAM preview this. Select all the layers and right click and click on pre-compose. Set the name as lower third and click on move all attributes and click OK. Press P to bring up the position property. And at 15 frames mark, create a keyframe for position. And at 4 second 15 frame mark, create a keyframe with the same position values. And at 5 second mark, set the position value to -960. At the start of the timeline, set the position value to -960. Now RAM preview this. Select all the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now RAM preview this. Now that's it. Now let's see the output once again. I hope you enjoyed this video. The music used in this video is from No Copyright Sounds. The track is called Time, made by Syncone. I will leave a link in the description. If you want the track, you can choose that. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Also, if you have anything to ask, feel free to comment down below. Once again, thanks for being here. This is Raudran, signing off.